over time, a very substantial portion and potentially all of the taxpayer investment in General Motors will be returned. But I'm by certainly no means would say that I am highly confident that that will occur.
Well, you just heard it. Ron Blum, a senior advisor to the president's auto task force, saying that he is not confident taxpayers will ever get their bailout money back in this whole mess.
Well, that was relatively honest. Live with us right now from D.C., Alabama Senator Richard Shelby. He's the ranking member of the Senate Banking Committee. Senator Shelby, what did you learn yesterday that might make you feel better about the bankruptcy, or are you still upset about the way that the car companies went into the bankruptcy?
Absolutely. I didn't learn anything yesterday that would make me feel better about the government intervention in the auto industry. What we learned yesterday confirmed my worst fears. We don't know, one, how long the government will be owning General Motors, for example. What is the exit strategy? They don't really have one yet. Someone has already described it, said, look, this is an economic Vietnam, easy to get in, hard to get out. What's the end game, the exit strategy? They don't have one, and I don't believe the money will ever be paid back.
Right, because when you look at the facts and the figures, and I'm not a mathematician, but you don't need to be one to find out that you'd have to sell a heck of a lot of cars over the next 5 to 10 years to be able to pay back the taxpayer. But let me ask you this, Senator Shelby. You were advocating that the car makers go into bankruptcy a long time ago. Would they have been better off in bankruptcy like that than this structured bankruptcy where many argue the unions were the only people who benefited?
Absolutely, they would have been better off. 6 months ago, I said it was inevitable they go into bankruptcy. It was the only way to do it, to restructure under a normal Chapter 11. This was a political orchestrated Chapter 11 where the bondholders were ignored. A lot of the people with various claims legitimate claims against General Motors were ignored. Same thing with Chrysler. And who benefited here? The unions. And I don't understand it. And I don't know how the taxpayer will ever recoup their money.
I just want to know that I'm getting this, and from doing radio and talking to people, people are mad that this is a government takeover, and instead of running to buy American, are running from GM and Chrysler, if I'm to believe the interaction I'm having with our audience.
Well, I have deep concerns where the union is basically the big beneficiary here, and the government is owning it, and they're trying to compete in the marketplace. I don't see how they compete.
Senator Shelby, say hello to your wife, who I understand is watching right now and always watches us, whether you're on or not, so we appreciate it.
Senator Shelby, thank you.
Thanks a lot, and we'll see you soon.